Konnichiwa! Hi and hello! So let's begin the lesson 7 from Genki textbook. So the lesson 7 is about Kazoku no Shashin, the family photo or the family picture. Let's begin the kaiwa. Sui is showing a picture of her family to her roommate Michiko. Michiko, korewa Suu-san no Kazoku no Shashin desu ka? Is this Suu-san's family picture? Suu. Eh? Yes. Michiko. Suu-san wa dore desu ka? Suu. Kore desu. This one. So, Michiko is asking, where is Suu-san? So, Koko no toki wa megane wo kakete imasu. I used to wear spectacles when I am in high school. Koko no toki wa megane wo kakete imashita. Michiko. Kawaii desu ne. Suu. Kore wa chichi desu. Is this your father? So Michiko is telling kawaii desu ne, which means so cute. And Suu is telling, kore wa chichi desu? Is this your father? Amerika no kaisha ni tsutomete imasu. Amerika no kaisha ni tsutomete imasu. Which means he works for an American company. Michiko, sega takakute kakkoii desu ne. So he is so tall and he looks too good. Kore wa onee-san desu ka? Is this your elder sister? Suu. Eh? Yes. Onee wa kekkon shite imasu. My sister is married. Ima souru ni sunde imasu. Now she lives in Seoul. Kodomo ga hitori imasu. She has one child, Sansai desu, and he is 3 years old. Michiko, so desu ka? Ah, nekko ga imasu ne. Oh, is it so? There is a cat. Demo, chotto futotte imasu ne. It looks little fat. Suu, eh? Yoku tabemasu kara. So, because of eating. Michiko's phone rings. Robato. Moshi moshi. Michiko-san. Hello, Michiko. Ima, nani o shitte imasu ka? So, what are you doing now? Ima, nani o shitte imasu ka? Michiko. Betsu ni nani mo shitte imasen. Ima, Suu-san no shashin wo mitte imasu. So, I am nothing particular. But I am looking on Suu's family photograph. Robato. So desu ka? Is it so? Omoshiroi DVD wo karimashita kara? So is it so? There is an interesting DVD I borrowed. Yokatta kara. Yokattara. Mi ni ikimasen ka? So if it is good for you, can you please, wouldn't you come and watch it? Michiko, ii desu ne. It's good. Suu-san mo, issho ni itte mo ii desu ka? So, is it okay for you? Should I bring the Suu-san also? Robato, mochiron. Michiko, ja, sugu ikimasu. Okay, well, we will come soon. Let's see the tango. Ane, elder sister. Apato, apartment. Imoto, younger sister. Uta, song. Oji-san is grandfather. Ototo, younger brother. Otoko no hito, man. Oni-san, older brother. Onesan, older sister. Obasan, grandmother or old woman. Onna no hito, woman. Kaisha, company. Kazoku, family. Kami, hair. Kyodai, brothers and sisters. Kuchi, mouth. Kuni, country or place of origin. Kuruma, car. Gemu, game. Kombini, convenience store. Sakuru, club activity. Shokudo, cafeteria. Chichi, my father. Dei, DVD. Haha, my mother. Me, eyes. Megane, glasses. So, let's see the E adjectives. We already know we have two adjectives. E adjectives and na adjectives. Atamaga E, the bright, clever and smart. Kawaii, cute. Segatakai, tall. Sega hikui, short. Nagai, long. Hayai, fast. Mijikai, short. For nagai, it is mijikai. Let's see the na adjectives. Shinsetsu, kind. Shinsetsuna, kind. Benrina, convenient. These are the na adjectives. Let's see the U verbs. The verbs also, we have three verbs. U verbs, ru verbs and irregular verbs. Let's see the U verbs. Utau, to sing. Kaburu, to put on the hat. Shiru, to get to know. Shitteimas, I know. Shirimasen, I don't know. Next, sumo, to live. Haku, to put on. Items below the waist, we call it as haku. Futoru, to gain weight. Futteimas, to be on the heavy side. So, let's see the ru verbs. Kakeru, to put on the glasses. Kiru, to put on the clothes. So, kakeru, hiku, haku, sorry, kakeru means to put on the glasses. Haku, to put on the clothes to the lower body. And kiru, to put on the clothes above the waist. And sutomeru, to work for. Yaseru, to lose weight. Yasette imasu, to be thin. Let's see the irregular verbs. Kekkonsuru, to get married. Let's see the adverbs and other expressions. Ga means but. Nani mo plus negative, not anything. Nin, counter for people. Hitori, one person. Futari, two people. Betsuni, nothing in particular. Moshi moshi, hello. Mochiron, of course. Yokattara, if you like. So let's see the grammar part. Teiru, a verbal te form which is followed by the helping verb iru, means either of the following: an action in progress or a past event that is connected with the present. Which of these two senses, so an action in progress or a past event that is connected with the present, we call it as teiru. So which of these two senses given a given verb is used in a larger extent determined by the semantic characteristics of the verb. So, the verb we have learned so far can be roughly divided into three groups based on the semantics. Verb that describes the continuous state. Verb that describes the activities that last for some time. Verb that changes, that are more or less instantaneously. We have not seen any group 1 verbs. We have not seen many group 1 verbs. So far we only have aru and iru. So the te forms of these verbs are never used together with the helping words iru. So we will have nothing to say about them in this section. Many verbs belong to the group 2. They include the verbs like taberu, yomu, matsu. When the te form of the verbs in this group are followed by the helping verb iru, we have the sentence of describing an action in progress. For example, Susan va. Susan va ima benkyo shite imas. Su is studying right now. Susan va ima benkyo shite imas. Takeshi san va eiga no hon wo yonde imas. Takeshi is reading a book in English. You can also use te imas to describe what a person does by occupation or by habit. The first example below therefore has two interpretations. The first one, you are teaching English right at this moment, and second one, you are an English teacher but are not necessarily in the class right now. The second example means the Mary is in the habit of studying Japanese, but of course she does not spend 24 hours a day doing so. Like, watashi wa eigo wo oshiyatte imasu. Watashi wa eigo wo oshiyatte imasu. I am teaching English. Watashi wa ikimono gaku wo oshiyatte imasu. I am teaching biology. The distinction between iru and aru we learned in the lesson 4 do not apply to this helping words te iru. You can use te iru both for living things and for inanimate things. Mary san wa mainichi ni nihongo wo benkyo shite imasu. Verbs in group 3. Mary studies Japanese every day. The verbs in group 3 describes the stages from one state to another. If you get married, kekkon suru. For example, your status changes from being to single to being married. With these verbs, te iru indicates a past occurrence of the change which has retained its significance until the present moment. In other words, te iru describes the result of the change. Like, Yamashita sensei wa kekkon shite imasu. Professor Yamashita is married. Michiko-san wa mado no chikaku ni suwatte imasu. Michiko-san wa mado no chikaku ni suwatte imasu. Machiko is seated near the window. Here are some examples of the verbs that are commonly used in te iru framework. Like motsu, motte iru. Su-san wa okane wo taku-san motte imasu. Su has a lot of money. Shiru, shitte iru. Yamashita sensei wa haha wo shitte imasu. Professor Yamashita knows my mother. Futtoru, futte iru. Tomu-san wa chotto futotte imasu. Tom is little overweight. Yaseru, yasette iru. Watashi no ototoe wa tottemo yasette imasu. Kiru, kitte iru. Mary san wa t-shirtsu o kitte imasu. Mary is wearing a t-shirt. Among the verbs we have learned so far, verbs such as okiru, iku, kaeru, kuru or wakaru, dekakeru or noru, suwaru, shinu, kesu, wasureru, kariru, okiru, kariru, oriru and motteiru, tsurette kuru, kekkonsuru, futoru, yaseru, kiru belongs to group 3. In most of the cases, you can determine whether a verb belongs to the group 3, group 2 or group 3 by checking if the verb allows for a phrase describing the duration, such as ichijikan. Compare for example, watashi wa kyo ichijikan hon wo yomimashita. I read a book for an hour yesterday. Watashi wa ichijikan shinimashita. I died for an hour. So which is also not ungrammatical. So yomu, this belongs to group 2, and shinu belongs to group 3. In lesson 9, we will observe that this result of change reading is actually not restricted to verbs in group 3, but can also be associated with those in group 3, group 2 in certain context. Note that the sentence do not mean Professor Yamashita is getting married. The negation of shitte imasu is shirimasen without the teiru formation. Let's see the okiru means wake up. Okiteiru. Otosan wa okitte imasu. Dad is up and awake. Sumu, sundeiru. Kazoku wa Tokyo ni sundeimasu. Sutomeru, sutomette imasu. Watashi no ane wa Nihon no kaisha ni sutomette imasu. My older sister works for Japanese company. Watashi no otto wa Nihon no kaisha ni sutomette imasu. My husband works for Japanese company. Note that the verbs like iku and kuru belongs to this group. Thus, itteiru and kitteiru indicate the current states that results from prior moments, not moments that are currently in progress. You may want to be careful with the following sentence. For example, chugoku ni itte imasu. Somebody has gone to China. And or not she is going to China. Somebody has gone to China or is in China. Chugoku ni itte imasu. Uchi ni kitte imasu. Somebody has come over to visit. Uchi ni kitte imasu. Somebody is not coming over. So finally, a note on conjugation, the helping verb iru conjugates as ru verb. So thus we have along forms of the following example. Let's see the present. Tabette iru. Tabette imasu. Tabette imasen. Tabette imashita. Tabette imasen deshita. So this is for continuous things. Mary san wa kami ga nagai desu. So to describe someone who has long hair, one could say Tomu san no kami wa nagai desu. Tom's hair is long. But in fact, that would be a far more natural in Japanese to say Tomu san wa kami ga nagai desu. So Tom's has long hair. As for Tom, he has long hair. So this applies not only to discussion of the length of one's hair, but also describe the person's physical attributes in general. See the body parts section at the end of this lesson for names of the body parts. Like A san wa mega oki desu. A san wa mimi ga chizai desu. A san wa te ga oki desu. A san wa ashi ga chizai desu. A san wo me ga kawaii desu. So, idiomatic allocations we have. Se ga takai means tall. Se ga hikui, short. Atama ga ii is bright. Te forms for joining sentence. In the last lesson, we discussed the use of te form to join the sentence ii and na adjectives. And this, after the noun, we have the te forms, which can be used to combine two elements to form longer sentence. For example, te form of an ii adjective is formed by substituting kutte for the final ii. So the te form of the na adjective and a noun plus des sequenced in the form of adding de to the base of the noun. So for e adjectives, ku te. For na adjectives, de. For example, yasu e. Yasukutte. E. Yokutte. And genki na. Genki de. Nihonjin des. Nihonjin de. So noun plus adjective. So noun plus des. Ano miso no tabemono wa yasukutte oishii desu. The food at that restaurant is inexpensive and delicious. So, hotelu wa kirei de yokatta desu. The hotel was clean and we were happy. Yamashita sensei wa nihonjin de goshu sai gurai desu. Goju Sai Gurai desu. Professor Yamashita is Japanese and he is about 50 years old. Next, verb stem plus ni iku. If a person moves to another place in order to do something, we can describe their movements and its purpose this way. Destination of the movement, ni plus iku, kuru and kayeru. The purpose of the movement is a phrase consisting of the verb, its object, so forth. Verb describing the purpose of the movement must be in the stem forms. So stems, as we learned in the lesson 3, as a part you get by removing mas from the verbs. So the present tense long forms like taberu, tabemas, yomu, yomimas, etc. I went to a departmental store to buy a bag. Depato ni kaban wo kai ni ikimashita. So Mary san wa nihon ni nihongo o benkyoshini kimashita. Mary has come to Japan to study Japanese. So counting people. The counter for the people is nin. But one person and two person are irregular, like hitori, futari. Hitori, one person. Futari, two people. San nin, three people. Yon nin, four. Four people. Go nin, five people. Roku nin, six people. Shichi nin or nana nin, seven people. Hachi nin, eight people. Kyu nin, nine people. Jiu nin, ten people. So, nan nin maska. Nani ni maska. So how many people are there? You can also use some nouns like kaimono for the purpose of the phrase, as in depato ni kaimono ni ikimashita. I went to the departmental store for shopping. So to count people in a class, for example, you add nin after the noun and the particle ga and say, so the person. So, person ga x nin imasu. For example, watashi no kurasu ni wa su. So, watashi no kurasu ni suweden jin no gakusei ga hitori imasu. There is one Swedish student in our class. The place expressions are often followed by ni or ni wa instead of ni in this type of the sentence. So, and next, yogen noto means expression note, like asobu and asobu means to play. To spend time pleasantly or to play social call. So kodomo no toki yoku tomodachi to asobimashita. When I was a child, I often played with friends. Senshu no shumatsu wa Tokyo ni asobi ni ikimashita. I went to Tokyo to have fun last weekend. Watashi no uchi ni asobi ni kitte kudasai. Please come and see us. So note that to play to our user below the requires the different words. Sports, to play tennis, like tennisu o suru. To play games, game o suru. To play cards, toramfu o suru. Like playing instruments, to play the guitar, so gita o hiku. So let's see. Shiru and Vakaru. If you don't know the answer to a question but should have thought about it, you should say Vakarimasen instead of Shirimasen. So let's see the dialogue 4, lesson 4 dialogue 2 for example. Shirimasen is such a constant would sound rude, imply you that your arrogance on that matter is none of the inquirer's business. So these and all are the practice. So this is about the family members. So let's complete with the family members and body parts. Kazoku no yobikata. Kazoku no yobikata. The family members. So father, otosan, referring on other's family. And here it is referring to yours. In the formal situations, it is chichi. Informal, otosan. And otosan or papa, addressing yours. Like mother is okasan or haha. Okasan. So informal is okasan. And okasan or mama. Older brother, oni-san. Referring to yours, ani. Ani is formal and oni-san is informal. Or addressing yours, oni-chan. Oni-chan. The older sister, one-san. And referring to yours, ane is formal and ane-san, informal. Addressing yours, Ane-chan. Let's see the younger brother, Ototo. When you are referring about yourself also, when you are referring others' family, Ototo-san. When you are referring about yourself, Ototo. Younger sister, Imototo-san. Imototo-san. When you are referring someone else's younger sister, when you are referring about yours, Imoto. Husband, Goshujin. When you are referring someone else's husband. When you are referring to yours husband, Shujin or Otto. Or in an informal situation, Danna Uchinohito. Danna or Uchinohito. Like when you are referring about yours, Otto-san. Let's see the wife, Oku-san. Oku-san. Or when you are referring about yours, Kanashi or Tsuma. Kanashi or Tsuma. Or informal situations, Oku-san or Ome-san. Yome-san. Yoku-san or Yome-san. Or Oka-san. Grandfather, Oji-san. When you are referring about yours, Sofu. Sofu or Oji-san. Oji-chan. Grandmother, Oba-san, Soba. Soba, Oba-san and Oba-chan. For child, Oko-chan, Oko-san. Oko-san is for child. Uchinoko, Uchinoko. There are many kind of kinship terms in addition to those listed in the table above. Equal or younger members of your family can be described
addressed by given name instead of kinship terms. As the table indicates, the term used for a particular type of family members varies according to the following situations. Speaking about someone else's family. Speaking about your own family in formal situations such as job interviews. Speaking about your own family in a casual situations. Speaking to your family. And Tanaka-san no Oto-san wa nansai desu ka? So if it is formal, Chichi wa goju sai desu. Informal, Oto-san wa goju sai desu. So how old is your father, Mr. Tanaka? My father is 50 years old, which is formal. And in the informal situations, my father is 50 years old. You have to tell Oto-san. You can also address the members of your family with the terms that the youngest member would use. For example, a wife can call her husband as Oto-san or Papa. And a mother can call her oldest son as Oni-chan. So, mother, Oni-chan, Oto-san ga matte imasu yo. Son literally means older brother. Your father is waiting. Oni-chan, Oto-san ga matte imasu yo. So, this is all about the family. Useful expressions. Karada no buffoon. Karada no buffoon. Parts of the body. Kami, hair. Me, eyes. Mimi, ears. Hana, nose. Kuchi, mouth. Yubi, fingers. And ha, teeth. Te, hand. Kubi, neck. Atama, head. Kao, face. Kata, shoulder. Mune, chest. Senaka, back. Onaka, stomach. Oshiri, buttocks. Ashi, foot. So these are the body parts. These are the very important body parts we have to be known. So this is all about the lesson 7. Kazoku no shashin. Okay, my dear friends, we'll see you in the next video. Arigatou gozaimasu.